much. That was your reaction to today's event?
Well, you know, today was really, really special. To share it with my family on the field and my extended family with the football team, and especially with that particular class, that 97 class. It was kind of the foundation of a lot of what we accomplished here. I think they were the number one recruiting class in the country in 94, and it turned out to be that we won an SEC championship with them, and then really a lot of those guys were part of the 98 national championship game. So very appreciative. I laughed so hard last night that my side hurt. Gary Fair was kind of emceeing. It was a blast, and heard some things that I really didn't probably want to know about, you know, but that we all laughed about. But it was fun. It was fun to share it with the Tennessee people. I've already said this before, but it's really true. You know, with something like this, you'd have to have 10,000 tickets to take to New York to thank everybody that had a part in it. You know, starting with my family, my wife being so supportive, and then obviously a lot of great coaches that were very loyal to Tennessee for a long time, and a few great sports writers, and a bunch of great players. You know, I was watching those film videos. You know, we had the same videos last night. I said, my gosh, you know, we were really good. There was 15 pros came out of that class. So it was fun. It's been a fun day. It's been a day that I've looked forward to. Certainly look forward to New York. Appreciate Peyton coming back. You know, I mean, I appreciate all the guys coming back, but it was particularly hard for him because he's still playing and everything. And I know he wouldn't have missed that 97 group anyway, but it was good that he was here. Because he was an awful big part of all of that. Any other questions?
I was going to ask you, how good is this Alabama team that just going against?
Well, they look pretty good, you know. I've seen them, I guess, two or three times this year on television. And statistically, you don't do some of the things that they're doing without being pretty talented, and they are. Our guys are fighting them pretty hard right now, tooth and nail. You not give up the big plays, and offensively just help our defense a little bit more, you know, keep them off the field. Try to keep Alabama's offense off the field a little bit more.
As a Tennessee guy, is it painful to see all that crimson out in the stands?
You know, I mean, from the number of people that are in the stadium. But I was really pleased at the reception that they gave us as a family. The respect there is mutual, and you know, I paid attention. There was a lot of people showing their respect for what we've accomplished, and I do really appreciate that. There was days that it was hard for them to get tickets here,
right?
You know, and we'll get back to that, I'm sure, someday.
Sorry. Did you talk to Darren much? Do you guys visit very often?
You know, when he asks, you know, I'll always talk and return his calls and things. You know, a few times here and there, we'll sit and we'll visit. We've had a couple, you know, three or four, I guess, you know, personal face-to-face meetings, you know, at my house or someplace or another, so his house. So I'm glad to try to help any way that I can. But I'm certainly not going to be looking like I'm interfering in any way. I'm not. Wouldn't do that.
You've been around the league a long time. Is the landscape as competitive as ever right now? Or do you think it's
you know, I have been around the league a long time. When all the officials come up and say hello to you before the game, you know, you've been around a while. It's great seeing a lot of those guys. What was your question?
Is it more competitive than ever, or what it's always been?
You know, it's always been competitive, and I mean, you know, maybe there's another six rather than five, you know, ranked teams, or seven rather than six. But, you know, what's going on in this league is the same thing that was going on in the 90s. It's just maybe different people. You know, you better bring your A game every week. And it's not far from the penthouse to the outhouse either.
How far is it from the outhouse to the penthouse? Not the Tennessee's in the outhouse. Can Tennessee be back in the penthouse?
Absolutely. I mean, we've got too great a history and tradition and facilities, and you know, I think everybody's working really much better in the same kind of direction. For a while, we were splintered all over the place, but I think Derek's doing a good job. But I think they've heart. you know, was trying to get everybody focused in the right direction. I spoke to a group from the Development Council yesterday. Fidelity had done a nice endowment of a scholarship in honor of the Hall of Fame deal. And I mean, you got the collection of really, really smart people, really, really bright people, people that love the university, and the chancellor and the president and the athletic director and everybody there. And they're all pulling to get the same things done. Campus-wide, but really athletics especially. So I think we can absolutely get back to where we went. I mean, this league is as tough as it's ever been. Missouri and A&M will have something to say about, you know, who goes to the next level up or down. You know, when they come in, that's just the way it is. Same thing has happened when we went to divisional play. You know, it separated the real men from the boys.
If the school makes a change anywhere, Phillip, and hits on the wrong guy, I mean, how tough is that to recover from?
Well, I don't know what you refer to my situation or just period, but, you know, I mean, there was an awful lot of good chemistry and stuff that all went a lot of different ways, and we've got to get all that pulled back together. You know, I'm hopeful that we can. Winning helps a lot of things. You know, my second year, and this is about this 94 team as much as anything. It's real easy to say, well, I get asked all the time, who's your favorite team? And that's impossible to answer, you know, or who's your favorite player? That's impossible to answer. But, you know, 98, obviously special. A lot of good teams around that 97 special. But that 1994 team started 1-3. I asked him, I said, who are you going to listen to? Are you going to listen to the media? Or do you think we can't coach and you can't play? Or are you going to listen to your mom or girlfriend who thinks it's everybody's fault but yours? Or are you going to listen to us as a coach and staff? And that's pulling the same direction. You know, Doug Dickey and Joe Johnson and all of us were pulling in the same direction. And we turned it around, won, I think, 7 of the next 8 in the bowl game. But most importantly, laid the foundation for the best era of Tennessee football, modern football, after that. And that's what we need to do. Let's all get focused on the same page, pulling in the same direction, and have a big win somewhere that makes a difference, and get going in the direction we want to go.
What was that big win plan?
Well, the next game was Washington State, and we beat them 13-12, I think, or something like that. You know, 10-9, something. I mean, it was a really, really close ball game. I don't know, reversed to Nilo Silva, I think, or somebody like that. But, you know, you're always going to have a signature win somewhere along the way. And, you know, the next year, 95, was a pretty good bunch of guys playing football. Great year. Great night.
Anybody else?
Thanks. Appreciate it. You're welcome.